दहरि तृप्ति हरि मगारि सहि रम पद
वंदे संगीतम। When I say वंदे संगीतम, I also wish to offer my pranams to some of the beautiful ragas that help us. You know, ragas can help us create a good mood, erase all negative emotions, create a feeling of wellness, and maybe it can even cure illness. Suppose we were to pick the queen of all the ragas, my choice would be Kalyani. This Kalyani is an ancient raga, no doubt about that, but it has taken various forms. If you look into the books, theory books, we find a lot of description being given about Kalyani here in South India, migrating to North India with a different form, coming back to South India. There have been a lot of changes, but Kalyani, the core emotion and the core swaras of the Kalyani have remained the same. The Trinity, to start with, have contributed immensely through this raga. Take Tyagaraja for example. He was a person who could convey so much of emotions, so many emotions, in so many kritis. In fact, I think he has composed around 20 kritis in Kalyani. But every kriti has a different feel. Each one has a different sthayi, that's a different matter. For example,
Nidhishala Sukama Ramani Sundarini
Tarastayi, Madhyastayi, Mandrastayi
Yeta Unara.
He goes on, he uses all the styles. Why I am saying this? Because when you come to Shyama Sesi, it's going to be different. And look at the emotions that he has conveyed. And emotions as ragas allowed itself to be used by the composer. Bhakti.
Bhajana seyave manasa parama bhakti to bhajana seyave manasa.
Talking about bhajanai, bhakti, Kalyani fits in well. You want to welcome someone? Song is there.
Amma ravamma tulasammananu palimpavamma satatamo padamule namminanamma amma ravamma.
Amma ravamma. Amma, please come home. Come. Well, suppose you want to convey a profound policy. Don't chase money. Rama Bhakti is important. This is the philosophy of life. To convey even such profound statements, Kalyani is of use.
Nidhishala Sukhayama Ramuni Sannidhi Seva Sukhayama Nijamukha Balkumanasa Nidhisala Sukhama.
Nidhisala Sukhama. Is money alone enough? No. Rama Bhakti is very important. Here, he not only stresses the importance of Rama Bhakti, but also, he doesn't speak ill of money. He said money is also necessary. Sala Sukhama. Well, there's a very interesting thing that Kalyani has offered to Tyagaraja. It has offered him to ask questions to Rama and a kriti full of questions. Can you imagine a kriti full of questions? There can be one question or two questions in a kriti. Understandable. Full.
Yeta unnara நிலக்கட நீரா
கொஸ்டின்
சீதா கௌரி வாகீஸ்வரி ஸ்ரீரூப மூலந்த
ஆர் யூ இன் த ஃபார்ம் ஆஃப் சீதா கௌரி ஆர் யூ இன் த ஃபார்ம் ஸ்ரீரூப மூலந்த கொஸ்டின்
பூகமலார்க்க நிலன பமூலந்த
Are you in the five elements of this earth? Bhumi, Akasham, Jalam, etc.
Loka Kotu Landa.
There's so many words. Are you there?
Shri Karuda Kutyaga Raja Kararchita சிவ மாதவ பிரம்ம சிவ மாதவ பிரம்ம துலயந்த
ஆர் யூ தேர் இன் த ஃபார்ம் ஆஃப் சிவா பிரம்மா விஷ்ணு வேர் ஆர் யூ ஸோ த கிருதி ஃபுல் ஆஃப் க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் அண்ட் திஸ் கேன் நாட் பி எக்ஸ்பிரஸ் டு சம் அதர் ராகா தட் கல்யாணி பிகாஸ் கல்யாணி இஸ் சோ டைனமிக் Talking of the dynamism of Kalyani, Muthuswami Dikshitar chose to employ the bhakti element of it. And he being an Ambal Bhakta, there are at least three compositions which are very popular of Muthuswami Dikshitar in Kalyani. One is Bajare Rechita, Kamalambam Bajare, and Abhayamba in Kalyani. In all these three kritis, Muthuswami Dikshitar has not failed to mention the name of Kalyani.
Nijarupa dana daksha charanam arunam nityam kalyani sharvani bhajare
He is singing the praise of Balambika and of course she being the goddess Ambal. The name Kalyani automatically comes there. The various reasons for why he has chosen Kalyani as a second raga for Kamalamba Avarnam series. One popular version is that Kakara Rupa Kalyani, Kalyani occurs as a second nama in Lalita Trishadi. And that is why he chose Kalyani as a second raga for Kamalamba Avanam. That could be possible. Another thing is that the two has some significance with Ambal because she is a kinetic force. Shiva is a static force. If Sapas are considered stationary and Rishabham is considered as a static force, Gandharam automatically becomes the kinetic energy. And that is why probably he chose to start Kamalamba Avaram with Ga.
Kamalamba Bhajare.
These are all just the inferences that we can draw from these kritis. It's very difficult to say that this is why he created this. That Dikshitar alone can say it. But we students, when we approach these kritis, we find certain things very revelating. Okay. Again, in Kamalamba Avarnam, he mentions the raga Kalyani.
Nitya Kalyani Katyayani.
The Kriti Abhayamba.
Abhayavaradapani Aliveni Mashitamavani Kalyani.
Now coming to Swama Shastri, there are only two kritis which are very popular in Kalyani by Swama Shastri. There's another one which is not very popular. I saw it in the books, but I never heard it. One,
பிரணவரா லீச்சி ப்ரோ உமுனினோ நேரணம் மிதி.
The same pattern, he has composed a song in Sanskritam.
Himadri sute pahimam varade paradevate.
And the second song is a real beauty.
Thalli ninnu nera nammina novinave.
Interestingly, one gentleman did a graphic representation of these two kritis, Thalli Ninnu Biranavara, and it was found that Shyama Sastri employed the Gandharam to the maximum extent, around 66% or something, and touched the other swaras only after employing this Gandharam for around 60 to 65%. This is not the case with Tyagaraja or Dikshidhar. They used all the swaras. Maybe this a little more, this a little less, but they use all the swaras. But Shyama Sastri was harping on Gandharam. Just look at these two kritis.
Thalli ninnu nera gagaga biranavara leechi brugamapa umu ninnu amageri neranam miti.
Everywhere it is centered around the Gandharam. Shyama Sastri, if he was so very particular about this Gandharam, Dikshidhar was so particular about creating a palindrome chittaswara for Kabalamba Avarnam Kalyani. Of the Kabalamba corpus, only Kalyani has the chittaswaram and it is in palindrome. Palindrome means, if you put it the other way around, it becomes the same thing for Malayalam, Malayalam. This sort of a status is given only to Kalyani. But don't think Kalyani is just for Mangalam, it is also for disgust. It has been used in Padams. And in Tamil Padam by Kavi Kunjara Bharati, you will find that the Kalyani is expressing the most frustrative statements.
Konjatana mayaval minji pesida adar kanji bayandu mela kenji girir ayyo yenganum ayyo gaga gamari.
We never thought that gamari can be used as a disgust. It has been used. Dikshidhar's disciple Ponnaiya Pillai created a remarkable composition. He used this Varja Prayogam, that Varja means you delete certain notes and use it. In Kalyani, when you delete Sa and Pa and sing it, it's a marvel.
Gamadani rigiri namagiri nida dagiri gari ga nida nida dagiri gari Oyamba saurambha mukabimba kuchakumba darabimba jagadamba brihadamba vinave Nijambuka pada saroja mulmanambu nan sadani lipitambaramuto bhajana seyuchunam mamari marini.
And it starts with a swarakshanam.
Ni sarisa.
Swarakshanam. This is a genius. Shyama Sastri's son, Subrahi Sastri, who also happened to be the disciple of Tyagaraja, created just one composition in Kalyani. And that has stood the test of time as much as his father's or his guru's.
Ninnu vinagati gana jagana, ninnu vinagati gana jagana vanaruhakshi dharma samvardhani.
There's an interesting story behind this kriti which I like to share. I still have goosebumps when I think of the story. As I told you, Subrahi Sastri was the son of Shyama Sastri, and Shyama Sastri sent him to learn from Tyagaraja. Tyagaraja and Subrahi Sastri were sitting in Dharma Samvardhani temple in Dharmambika's sannidhi. When in the presence of his guru, this composition was created. How would the guru feel? And how the shishya would have felt when he composed in front of his guru? And that is the history behind this composition. Another great thing is that the chittaswarams that are employed in this are sung by almost every musician when he is singing Kalyani Swaras.
Nidamagari damagari magari sari sa nidani sari gama pada pa nidamagari damagari maga.
Invariably, when you sing the Onnankalam Swaram in Kalyani, we employ this. Thus, Kalyani has been treated in different ways, very beautifully. And in Tamil compositions, Papanasam Sivar has given it a different lilt. Again, he has used his Sapasa Varja Prayogams and created one of the best charanams of a Kriti.
Niye Meenakshi Kamakshi Nilayatakshi Yenapala Peyarudan Engum Niye Meenakshi Kamakshi Nilayatakshi
Unnayellal Vere Gathi Illayamma. That's the composition.
Unnayellal Vere Gathi Illayamma Ulagillam Indra Annai.
Something very interesting happened to Kalyani, which most of us are still surprised. There's never been a Sangadi. It is never there. It's never seen in Kalyani at all. We never heard it. But one genius called G. Ramanadham, in one of his film music songs, Sindhanisi Maname, added this Sangadi to Kalyani. And all the musicians borrowed it. Today, if you don't sing this Kalyani, it's not considered Kalyani. But actually, this Sangadi is not prevalent in any of the Kalyani songs that we have seen so far. So one stroke can make such a big difference. Well, suppose I were to talk about the exponents of Kalyani. It's a very unbiased frame of mind. Not because they are my gurus, but I would place D.K. Pattammal and D.K. Jayaraman as one of the best exponents, because they followed a couple of things which were missed out by many of the musicians, not all. The Gandharam.
Gari. Gari.
The Re should be flat and the Ga should be oscillating.
Gama pada ni.
The Ni was never sung flat. They hardly sang it flatly. It was always an oscillation. And if another musician who followed this principle and also very clearly distinguished from Shankarapanam, for which he or she was famous for, it was Srimati Amma Subbalakshmi. She would make it very clear whether she was singing Kalyani or Shankarapanam. And the difference between Kalyani and Shankarapanam is just the madhyamam.
Pama
becomes Kalyani.
Pama gama pama ga
is Shankarapanam. But that is not the exact difference. The difference occurs even in the Gandharam Rishabhan, even without touching the Madhyamam.
Gari
becomes Kalyani.
Gari sa.
It becomes Shankarabharanam.
Rinana.
Automatically it becomes Shankarabharanam. Leave alone the Madhyamam. We don't need the Madhyamam to establish a difference between Shankarabharanam and Kalyani. And this, a person like Srimati M.S. Subbalakshmi, who was such an expert in singing Shankarabharanam, could sing Kalyani with as much felicity. Well, is Kalyani going to remain the same? It is not going to remain the same. It has changed over the years. Musicians have added Sangadi. Just like I said, one cinema musician, a great cinema musician he was, of course, could bring so much of difference with one stroke. Carnatic musicians can do a lot, and they have done it. There are many Sangadis which have crept into Carnatic music which are not found in the Trinity compositions. And this is bound to happen. But the soul of Kalyani, she always remains the queen of the ragas.
Dhari, 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 magari, sa.